Good morning, children. Now today we are going to do experiment 8B1. The aim of the experiment is to study the different parts of the circulatory and respiratory system of the human body and study their functions. So under circulatory system, what we have to do is we have to label the different parts of the heart. The main organ involved in circulation is the heart. So for this practical, this model of the heart will be kept for you, and you have to label these three parts A, B and C and write the function of the part. And you also have to draw the diagram of the heart. So you have to learn the diagram. Now, same thing we will be doing for respiratory system. We will keep the model of the respiratory system and you will only mark the parts which are told to you. So for this practical, you can either draw circulatory system or respiratory system, any one. And you have to name those parts which are only marked. In this case, it's A, B and C. So remember that from different parts of the body, deoxygenated blood enters and it reaches the right atrium. This upper chamber is called the right atrium. Okay? From the right atrium, this deoxygenated blood enters the right ventricle. Now, this deoxygenated blood from the right ventricle has to get oxygenated. It has to go somewhere to get full of oxygen. So from the right ventricle, it goes to the lungs through a vessel which is called the pulmonary artery. So this part here marked C is the pulmonary artery. Now remember that all arteries carry oxygen rich blood, oxygenated blood, except this particular artery which is called the pulmonary artery. So through this pulmonary artery, this blood that is deoxygenated goes to the lungs where it has to get oxygenated. Okay, so only these three parts you will have for your practical. So remember, from different parts of the body, blood enters the right atrium. So this part A is the right atrium. This upper chamber is the atrium. Then this right atrium will contract and this right ventricle will expand. So when the right atrium contracts, the blood from the right atrium is pushed down into the right ventricle. So B is the right ventricle. And then when B contracts, the blood from B is pushed out and it goes to the lungs through this vessel which is called the pulmonary artery. So the pulmonary artery takes this deoxygenated blood from the right ventricle to the lungs. Now these are the three parts that you have for exam. So you have to know A is right atrium. It collects deoxygenated blood from different parts of the body. Then you have to know B, this is right ventricle. It collects deoxygenated blood from the right atrium. And you have to know C for the practical. That's pulmonary artery, which takes the deoxygenated blood from the right ventricle to the lungs where it gets oxygenated. Now besides this, there are other parts. Okay, like for example, you have the left atrium. This is the left atrium. This is the right atrium. This side is the left atrium. The left atrium collects oxygenated blood from the lungs through the pulmonary vein. So this part will receive oxygenated blood. So once that blood gets full of oxygen in the lungs, that oxygenated blood from the lungs comes to the left atrium through the pulmonary vein. From the left atrium, then it goes here down into the left ventricle. Okay, so the left ventricle basically collects the oxygenated blood coming from the left atrium. And then from here, it has to reach different parts of the body. That blood, which is full of oxygen, has to reach different parts of the body. So it reaches all those different parts of the body like this. And it comes through this large vessel, which is called the aorta. So this is the aorta. The aorta is the largest artery in the body. So remember, from different parts of the body, the blood that's coming into the heart is deoxygenated. That deoxygenated blood enters the right atrium. Then the right atrium will contract and the right ventricle will expand. That time blood will flow from the right atrium to the right ventricle. Now this blood, which is deoxygenated, has to get full of oxygen, so it has to go to the lungs. So it goes to the lungs from here through the pulmonary artery. Then in the lungs it gets full of oxygen. That oxygen rich blood will come through the pulmonary vein into the left atrium. Then the left atrium will contract and the left ventricle will expand. So that time blood will go into the left ventricle. And from here it has to reach different parts of the body. This oxygen rich blood has to reach different parts of the body. So from here it comes like this, and through the aorta, which is the largest artery in the body, it reaches different parts of the body. So for this practical, that's experiment 8B1, you only have to draw any one diagram, either of the heart or the human respiratory system, and you have to label the parts of both the models of the heart as well as the human respiratory system. So for this one, it's only A, B and C. So A is right atrium, B is right ventricle, and C is pulmonary artery. Now we come to the human respiratory system. Now when we inhale, when we breathe in, we take in air rich in oxygen through the two openings, which are called the nostrils. So through the nostrils, air enters. That air is rich in oxygen. So that air, which is rich in oxygen, then will enter this part, which is called the nasal passage. And from here, air then enters into this part, which is called the trachea. Is that clear? Now this trachea is made up of rings of cartilage like this, and the trachea divides into two branches. These two branches are called bronchioles. So the right side branch, right side bronchiole, will enter the right lung, and the left side bronchus, sorry, not bronchioles but bronchus, will enter the left side lung. So remember, you take in air, that is inhalation. Air will enter the nasal passage. From the nasal passage, it goes into the trachea. The trachea divides into two branches called bronchi. By mistake, I said bronchioles. It's two bronchi. So right side bronchus will enter the right side lung, and this left side bronchus will enter the left side lung. Now, once this bronchus enters into the lung, it divides like this into smaller branches. These smaller branches are called bronchioles. And then each of them open into air sacs called alveoli, which are there in the lungs. So basically, you have to study only these three parts, X, Y and Z. X are the trachea, is the trachea. So the trachea carries the air to the lungs. And then this trachea bifurcates, it divides into two branches called bronchi. And these bronchi further divide into smaller branches called bronchioles. Then you have this part Y. This is nothing but the lungs. So this is the right side lung. This is the left side lung. So Y are lungs. So the lungs basically help in inhalation and exhalation. And then you have Z, which are these small dots which they have shown in the model. And Z are alveoli. So basically the alveoli are air sacs. Okay. These alveoli provide a surface area for exchange of gases. So they basically have a lot of blood vessels. So oxygen, which is taken in, diffuses into the blood, it enters the blood because those blood vessels are very fine. And then the carbon dioxide which is there in the blood enters back into the lungs through those blood vessels. And then when we exhale, that carbon dioxide is given out. So first we inhale air. Air enters through the two openings called nostrils. It enters the nasal passage. The air from here then enters X, which is the trachea. Trachea is made up of rings of cartilage. So the trachea carries the air, which is rich in oxygen, into the lungs. The trachea bifurcates, it divides into two. Each branch is called bronchus. This bronchus further divides into smaller branches called bronchioles. Then they enter these lungs. The lungs are the main organs of gaseous exchange, which help in inhalation and exhalation of air. And then the lungs are made up of air sacs, which are called alveoli. So all these dots that you see here, Z, are alveoli, which provide a surface area for exchange of gases. So with this, we have finished 8B1 practical. You have to draw any one diagram, either of the heart or this respiratory system, and you have to only label the parts that are marked. So for the heart, it's A, B and C, and for the lungs, it's X, Y and Z, and write the functions of those parts.